Myself, Neeru Kumari. Welcome to 11th Commerce classes of Subject Business Study. It's part 5 of chapter 2, that is Forms of Business Organization. Today we cover the topic Joint Stock Company. Let's start with the introduction. This type of company is suitable for large scale business. It attracts huge capital from the public. And it employ trained and experienced manager to run the business activities. Let's discuss about the main features of it. It is treated as an artificial person because it is created by law and run in the name of the company. Registration is necessary under Companies Act 2013, means these companies are registered under Companies Act 2013. Perpetual succession means its identity or company identity is distinct from its member, so its member death and insolvency not affect the continuity of its business. All the works done under the common seal because it is treated as an artificial person. Then transfer of share is possible in this type of company, and there is a separation of ownership and control found under this type of organization. How? Because its member, means the shareholders, are treated as an owner of the company. And when we talk about the control or the management, this company controlled and managed by the board of director who elected in the general meetings. Its member liabilities are limited to the extent of their capital invested. And last one is, it has separate legal existence, means company and its member both has separate legal identity or separate identity. Now we discuss about the advantage of the joint stock company. When we talk about its member liability, all the member has limited liability to the extent of their capital invested. Transfer of share is possible, means its member may transfer their share when they want. Perpetual existence, the death and insolvency of member, its member, not affect the continuity of the company. Growth and expansion, there is more scope for the growth and expansion because this type of company easily raise capital from the market. Efficient management, there is efficient management found in this type of company because management done by the professional experts. Large amount of capital. This type of firm has capacity to raise large amount of capital from the public or from the market. Now discuss about the disadvantage. There is complexity found in its formation. How? When we talk about its formation, there is lengthy and complicated procedure followed by the promoters for its establishment. Lack of secrecy. There is lack of secrecy found in this type of company because this company has to send their information to the Office of Registrar, not only your Office of Registrar, but this information also discussed in general public meeting. The next one is impersonal work environment. It is managed by the professional manager. Numerous regulation this company has to follow a large number of rules and regulation. Delay in decision, because decision are taken in the board meeting, that's why there is delay found in decision. Oligarchic management. Under this, democratic setup exists only on paper, but in reality its control lies in the hand of few people, that is board of directors. Conflict in interest, because large number of people are related or involved in this company, so there is conflict arises. The example of these group of people are shareholder, debenture holder, employee, director, etc. Now discuss about the type of company. There are three types of company: private limited company, public limited company, one person company. Let's discuss the main features of these type of company. Private limited company established as per section 268 of Indian Companies Act 2013. There is restriction found on the transfer of shares. When we talk about its membership, minimum 2 members or maximum 200 members found in this type of business. There is prohibit any invitation to the public, means this company prohibits to invite public. The next one is the public limited company. As this company or public limited company are registered as per Companies Act, and minimum 7 member and maximum, there is no limit of maximum number of member. There is no restriction on transfer of share, and this type of company invite general public to subscribe its securities. Private companies, which is the subsidiary of public company, is also treated as a public company. There are two type of company, public limited company found, that is company limited by guarantee and company limited by shares. The last type of company is the one person company. This type of company introduced in 2013 under section 3(1) of 2013's act. This company with only one person as its member, means this type of company has only one person as its member, and there is some requirement for this company, this type of company. First, Rule 3(1) provides that only a natural person and Indian citizen and resident of India. Means in order to open this type of company, the person must be natural person and he must be Indian citizen and also the resident of India. If this condition fulfilled, then this person is able to open the one person company. Other important thing is one person company compulsory convert itself into the public or private company in certain cases. It converted into private company when its capital is extinct or exceed from 50 lakh. and it converted into public company when its capital exceed from 2 crore. That's all for today. Have a nice day.